O God, who like a mother to us, and because of the sincere faith of our mothers, whom you have commanded us to honor, we come now to worship you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Shall we rise for the opening hymn? Again to Open Door Believers Chapel. We continue to remind you each week that we are a Plymouth Brethren Assembly. We're governed by a body of local elders. We are not a pastor-centered church. And our chief purpose at this assembly is to proclaim the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, whom to know is eternal life. So welcome once again.
She gave me life, showed me what was right, taught me not to fight the battles that weren't worth the fight. Right from the start, she held me close, and as time went on, she was strong enough to let me go. Her love that still remains. like a mother's love.
Thank you, Melissa and Alyssa, for that. That was lovely. If you're listening to the words of the song, that's one of the character traits of the Lord we serve. There's nothing we can do that affects His love for us. And that's why Christians, that's why people who identify as followers of Christ rest in the hope that there's nothing, no sin, nothing you could do could ever make God despise you and turn His back on you. And so mothers are kind of the closest thing on earth to that, because Nicole could tell you, no more patience. Need to pray about that. But thanks, mothers, for the love. And Melissa, Alyssa, that was really beautiful. Almost. At the end, almost. I was like, man up, no more, man up. Right? Thanks for that one. This time, in preparation for the message today, our scripture reading will be taken from Psalms 139, verse 10 to 16, and it will be read for us by our sister Sandra Williams.
Psalm 139, verses 10 through 17. Even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light about me be night. Even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is bright as the day, for darkness is as light with you. For you form me inward parts, my inward parts, you knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, my soul knows it very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed substance, in your book were written, every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, ladies. Really thank you, mothers, Melissa and Alyssa. Oh, that was beautiful. And the little laughter part, the little crowning, the touch. No, man, I started to make nice before, you know? No, when fathers do it, the man can dance, so. Huh? There's something special about Mother's Day. I don't know why. As no man say, a lot of churches, but they're going to celebrate motherhood. Wow. And today, I ask people here, no matter what you do, forget it. And I am grateful for motherhood. I am where I am today in my work for the Lord because of my mother. She was not working for the Lord like what you think, you know. Everybody think. When everybody gets spiritual, I mean, we serve the Lord. She take care of her picking them. She took care of her children. That is motherhood. She prayed for them. She encouraged them to go to church. She encouraged them to go to school to keep them clean. Should have served the Lord. Get that straight. She sacrificed for her children. You understand? You remember that? Motherhood. Today, we celebrate the faith of our mothers, which not only reflected God's love to us in Christ in a practical way, but it reminds us of our duty now, as we learned Wednesday night, to serve Him as she did and as she served us. Shall we rise? Let it be a time of commitment. committed himself to loving us, just loving us forever. And so in response, we say, Lord, I love you. Over the bottom of the page, under the heading there, Declaration. The Declaration is our congregational reading for the service. This is when we as a body of people offer back to the Lord his holy word in worship. Today it's taken from Psalm 116. We read together. Don't rush it. The Lord saved me from death. He stopped my tears and kept me from defeat. And so I walk in the presence of the Lord in the world of the living. I kept on believing, even when I said, I am completely crushed. Even when I was afraid and said, no one can be trusted. What can I offer the Lord for all his goodness to me? I will bring a wine offering to the Lord to thank him for saving me. In the assembly of all his people, I will give him what I have promised. How painful it is to the Lord when one of his people dies. I am your servant, Lord. I serve you just as my mother did. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Look at the last line again. I am your servant. Everybody again. Together. Not rush it. I am your servant, Lord. I serve you just as my mother did. This childlike prayer, oh Lord, I raise to you.
As my mother.
By six mothers. Great is thy faithfulness.
If you have felt the dark of night, questioning what is out of sight, He is the answer. He is the light. If you have felt the weight of sin, bound by the shame that's hemmed you in, He'll break the chains. He will forgive. Lift your wrestled with the ache of loss, and why this has been your road to walk. He bore your pain, He wore your
Wait on Him.
To the speaker, we go back for a lifetime. Her name is Dr. Charmaine Saunders.
You know, I thought about today, and I said, the only time I've been at this pulpit alone, of course I've been on the pulpit, on the stage, sorry, when I do cantata. I love cantata. And but the only time I've been on this pulpit solo was to do eulogies. And then I thought a little bit more, and I said, no, actually, Sister Lolly had given me an opportunity one Mother's Day to do sharing. And that was a beautiful experience for me. So when Nomar hinted that I should speak, I said, let me check my busy calendar. And I jokingly told him, best you catch me now before I start to charge, right? He said, Dickie always said charge. So here I am today, not doing a eulogy, but still I feel comforted that I have an opportunity to share. I want to share a little story about, it's called the story of everybody, somebody, anybody, and nobody. Once upon a time, there were four men named Everybody, Somebody, Anybody, and Nobody. There was an important job to be done, and everybody was asked to do it. But everybody was sure that somebody would do it. Anybody could have done it, but nobody did it. Somebody got angry about it because it was everybody's job. Everybody thought anybody could do it, and nobody realized that everybody wouldn't do it. It ended up that everybody blamed somebody, and nobody did that anybody could have done in the first place, did the job that anybody could have done in the first place. At last report, these four men were still arguing about the job they were supposed to do that still wasn't done. This story has no mothers or women in it. First Timothy 5:10 says, and is well known for her good deeds, such as bringing up children, showing hospitality, washing the feet of the Lord's people, helping those in trouble, and devoting herself to all kinds of good deeds. Motherhood is a gift from the Lord. It is, in fact, one of the many ways we can glorify and serve him. From the book quoted in Gregory Cleveland, Beholding Beauty by Pauline Books and Media, it says that the most important person on earth is a mother. She cannot claim the honor of having built Notre Dame Cathedral. She need not. She has built something more magnificent than any cathedral, a dwelling for an immortal soul, the tiny perfection of her baby's body. Mothers are closer to God, the Creator, than any other creature. God joins force with mothers in performing his act of creation. Some time ago, I read somewhere, and I love to read, so I'm always reading, that mothers are one of the first indications of the sovereignty of God in our lives. Throughout Scripture, motherhood is spoken of as a high and important calling. In fact, so importantly so, that in Isaiah 66:13, God utilizes the metaphor of mothers to describe the way he loves and cares for his children. Personally, I must state that motherhood was my greatest gift from God. It is sincerely the most important job and role that I possess. Not to say that being a wife is less important. However, my husband already has his own identity, his own way, and he's very set in those ways, his own way of doing things and making decisions that I have learned, though painstakingly so, to be submissive to him. But I've learned that our child, we both have the responsibility to raise her up in the way of the Lord. Introspectively, I must confess that motherhood has definitely presented a myriad of opportunities to grow in my understanding of God's love, God's mercy, and his grace. Indeed, there have been countless challenges, but all these challenges have a good purpose. Romans 5:3. And not only this, but we also exalt. You hear that word? Exalt. We also exalt in our tribulations, knowing that tribulation brings about perseverance. In Romans 5:4, it says, and perseverance, proven character, and proven character, hope. These are truths for all of us as mothers. Sometimes we find ourselves caught between our heart's desires and the heart of our child or children. We are not at war with our child or children, though they oftentimes think so. In fact, we are fighting for our child or children. My mom often reminded me that God gave us to them as parents for the purpose of raising us in the instruction and discipline of the Lord. So, exactly what does the Bible say about motherhood? Motherhood is a blessing. Psalms 127:3. Children are a heritage from the Lord, offspring a reward from him. Motherhood is ordained by God. It says so in Psalms 139:13. For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. Motherhood is full of hope, as per Proverbs 22:6. Start children off on the way as they should go, and even when they are old, they will not turn from it. Motherhood is full of joy. Proverbs 23:25. May your father and mother rejoice. May she who gave you birth be joyful. Motherhood is a calling. It's in Proverbs 31:28. Her children arise and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her. Motherhood is worthy of honor. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, so that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on the earth. Ephesians 6:1-3. In Proverbs 31:10-28, I'm using the King James Version here. It says, her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. A mother's instructions are by example, words and actions. I'd like to share a short version, a summarized version, of how I got baptized. It was back in late 2002, and Nicole Sutar, approached me as she normally does to greet and converse one evening just before prayer meeting. I believe on several occasions I've reminded Nikki of this instance, and both of us just chuckled. Nikki said in her pleasant, affirmative manner, as I was deliberating about baptism and just couldn't decide if I wanted to go fully underwater. She said in a nonchalant way, and please note, I cannot quote her verbatim because it was 20 years ago. She said something like, "Girl Charmaine, it's just water. Just go under and you will come out renewed. What do you have to lose? For sure, you and I know there is so much more to gain. Just water." That evening, I got home and I sent Namar a message that I would begin my sessions leading up to baptism. You know, at that time in my life, I had no idea that I was pregnant until some time after. And you know, even as I thought about it, Nikki also had something to do with my pregnancy. I think she had a Mother's Day. She was given an opportunity to speak for Mother's Day. And she spoke about barren women. I don't know why. But that day, she prayed and prayed about all women with barren wombs. And I thought she spoke directly to me. So, I share this to say that God had already selected me for motherhood, even before I conscientiously made a decision to be baptized. The Proverbs 31 mother is a saved, godly woman that loves the Lord and teaches her children to love God. Motherhood humbles you. Before I became a mom, I saw myself as a tenacious, vivacious, strong, and resilient individual. I definitely was not patient as I am now. I'm still not that patient. It was humbling for me to seek God's help and that of others and not be afraid to ask for help. God works best in weakness because his strength is exactly for those who are weak and needy, not for those who feel strong and independent. Motherhood teaches us rest. I am always supercharged, the Energizer Bunny. Get everything done. I was an involved parent, running from school shows, volleyball, football, and even basketball games, picking up Jasmine and her friends too. I think I felt guilty. Mom guilt, you know what that is? If I needed rest from it all, I felt mom guilt. I recognized I could not be physically, even mentally, in multiple places. Jesus was the perfect example and modeled for us spiritual and physical rest. Jesus' ability to rest was his humility at work. Motherhood teaches us perseverance in service. As we serve our children, we are following Christ's footsteps. He served in so many ways. Motherhood makes us like Christ when we submit to persevere in a life of faithful service to our children. Motherhood has drastically changed my life. And of course, as the oldest siblings, I had racked up a lot of mileage in my own experience of nurturing my siblings as well. Motherhood has made me stronger, giving me a true sense of worth and purpose. And it has definitely aided me in aligning my priorities. What is most certain, my heart has now experienced a love like no other from the moment my child began to grow in my womb. Psalms 139, 13 through 14 states, "For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well." So you see, God created us, but he specifically made us inside our mothers. Motherhood and the relationship Christ has with the church. The Christ church relationship provides us with a great model for motherhood. Christ sustains a special relationship to his body, the church. When I look at the great sacrifice Christ made by dying on the cross for us as sinners, his life, power, and righteousness given to us by unmerited favor, I am awed but can understand why mothers sacrifice so much for their children. Some mothers even die in childbirth or donate their kidney to save their child's life. Christ and his relationship with us demonstrates patience and faithfulness whilst we do everything else but follow his teachings and ways. He patiently accepts us back. I see this quality in all mothers. Their children stray, but they still remain faithful, and back in loving arms, they receive them when they opt to return. Christ's grace and our ability as a church to call out his name and call on him in time of need. It is through grace that God works effective change in our hearts and lives. How many of you here, and you can raise your hand, no matter what your age, still cry out for our mothers, the dead mothers or the ones that are alive? When we feel that there is no other one to help, we cry out for our mothers. Romans 5, 1 through 2 says, "Therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace in God, with God, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, we have also obtained access by faith into this grace in which we stand, and we rejoice in the hope of the glory of God." We have access to God's grace, and therefore we are eternally grateful that grace of God is more than just salvation, but also everything that we need for life and godliness. This grace can be found in our mothers, because they are these precious individuals who have chosen to access Christ's grace and have been changed by its influence. I can testify. As I grow in my own understanding of how my personal relationship with Christ impacts my role as a mother, I have become the greatest advocate of and for my child, nurturing and supporting her to ensure that she becomes the best version of herself. As a mother, I wanted to ensure that I taught our child how to have confidence and the importance of and value of believing in herself. I know from personal experience that it was critical for her to believe in herself. It would allow her to be whole, strong, and grant her the ability to grow with a healthy estimation of herself. I've grown to recognize and acknowledge that in order for me to truly love my child, and by extension, my family, I had to truly love myself and who I am to be able to freely and abundantly give love and support to my child and family. This love that flows abundantly causes me to work earnestly to ensure that my child has the knowledge and knowledge of the Lord and skills to survive and succeed this life. I want to close with a special blessing for all mothers here today. So I kindly ask mothers to kindly stand. Mothers, may God bless you with the wisdom, guidance, and grace to navigate the ups and downs of motherhood, and in some cases, grandmotherhood. And may you always feel his love and support, knowing that you are cherished and valued. May your life be filled with love, joy, and happiness. And may you continue to be a light in the lives of those around you. Be blessed.
All right, shall we rise? Praise God. More blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Close off with the words from Wednesday's Bible study. I thank God, whom I serve with a pure conscience, when I call to remembrance the genuine faith that is in you, which dwelt first in your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded is also in you. Therefore, I remind you to stir up the gift of God which is in you. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. God bless you. Thank you for worshiping with us today. Have a great and blessed Mother's Day.